We're in downtown San Francisco on a weekday at high noon as we watch the world's top slide railer and his sherpa.
My name is Joe Pizzetti. I'm a railing slider.
Awesome.
This is Grovesberg here. My best friend and accomplice is slide rail.
I don't slide. Railing sliding is inherently dangerous. You know, it's like surfing cement waves. Imagine the pain of a surfer, you know, crashing, but it's cement instead of water. And this is the sort of sport that he wants to do.
But Grovesberg's there in so many other ways.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I caught something at the bottom, I think. This was a great run, though, man.
It was a good run.
That felt good.
Now, I can repair those pants, and we got other pants. We just didn't bring them with us. We don't have the spare pants now,
oh, man,
so.
Come on, I want to take some more runs, man.
Grovesberg provides the voice of reason as we join the slide team for an evening workout.
One of my favorite slide areas, although it's also the land of temptation because, I mean, many of these rails, there's either some foliage or there's, you know, some concrete abutment, maybe a hump.
It's basically an iron mixed with some tungsten in it and a bit of brass.
What is it about this rail that I just love it? It's a short run. So it doesn't seem so special, but something about it. I mean, one of my favorite private sector rails right here.
Let's take a moment to look at the sport of slide rail. You've got angles of incline, surface composition, friction coefficients, humidity, pants rail technology, and a hell of a lot more. But what you really need to know is, you've got the slide, and you've got the slider. Men like the late Bone Cheek Moskowitz, legendary for the mid-slide cheek switch. The great McVail, also known as Birdman, champion wooder and master of transcendental sliding. The up-and-coming Jorge Mendez, who's pioneering the popular new form of style sliding. And reigning champion of slide rails, Joe Pizzetti. When you talk about Pizzetti, you're talking about one of the great asses in the sport. So now that you've got the basics, let's join the action as we watch Pizzetti and Grovesberg as they descend into the mighty lion, a slide notorious for eating up even the best of sliders.
Go overboard with these things.
Oh, I can't believe this. Oh, it's like burning. Feel that, man. Feel that. It's like on fire. Feel this. It's on fire. Don't touch my ass.
Friction.
That's all right. It's on fire, though. Burns, but burns so good.
So don't.
I'm not doing anything. Don't worry.
Let me prepare first.
I'm just looking.
It's like a little kid sometimes.
You're looking at one of the prime slides in the whole of the United States of America.
At 112 feet 9 inches with a 61 degree angle of incline, the lion slide seems like a suicide run.
Yeah, right now because of, you know, the way the sun's been beating on it, it's very dry, but it's still a little cool. So I'm thinking we're looking at a 7. I think you're gonna have to switch.
Yeah.
Just to have an ending.
With the lion looming below, we're getting a rare glimpse into what makes Pizzetti and Grovesberg such a great slide rail team.
This is where I just kick back and relax, let him do his thing, you know? He's laying out the pants, man. The guy's one of the great scientists of slide rail technology ever. I mean, hands down. There's no one out there like him. It's like an art form. I just watch it, relaxes me before my slides. You can see right there, there's one that I did a bunch of runs on. I never got around to washing. It's well worn. It makes a good pair of pants, a pants that slides fast, doesn't build up too much heat. That's a good pair of pants. That's what I like. And that's what he knows how to deliver. Time and time again.
Let's get it going.
You're wearing
man.
These because we expect
dude,
it to be foggy.
Dude, you're slowing me down. Girls, don't do this shit.
With a 60 plus with a short landing, let's stick with the plan and with the designs.
Me down.
We did the research.
I can't fucking believe you're here again.
What's up, Jackie?
Jackie Goldstein, Pizzetti's volatile lover and instrumental part of the Pizzetti training regimen, largely responsible for sculpting that ass.
How did they meet? Joe's looking for ways to toughen his ass up. He's got a perfect physique for slide rail, but the low body fat, the boniness, leads to a lot of injuries. And he hit upon the idea of a dominatrix to whip him into shape, and he found Jackie.
He was all ass all the time. Spank me harder, harder, on the left, you know, do the right again. Spank me, spank me.
Where have you been?
What? Oh, fuck.
Yeah, that's right.
I totally forgot. Listen, we're doing the film thing here.
Mm-hmm.
Just give me a minute.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to talk to the
guys.
Yeah,
you need another minute with your little boyfriend. You've got a girlfriend too, huh?
Guys, she's bent out of shape. Just kind of,
give me a minute to butter things on it.
I don't care about the goddamn slide. I've already been waiting for you for a fucking hour. You know what? Why don't you go fuck your little pack mule?
It's not my pack mule, it's my sherpa.
One of the great moments in slide rail history, and our cameraman missed it. Wow. The man in the red hood cold sliding the lion. It's gotta be a low blow to Pizzetti.
Don't worry.
I don't feel like dealing with these guys right now.
Get your head together. He needs a little time. He's a bit of a shock, but he'll be fine. We're gonna have a slide off. He's wearing denim. Denim's like training pants. It's like having pine tar on, you know, on your pants. But the slide off will show our... Wait, what are you doing?
I got it, man.
No, you're wearing the wrong pants!
Thanks for everything, Bruce.
R-I-C-E. All right, take care.
Yeah, I got it, man. I got it. Okay. Hey, Grozy, how's it going, man? I'm okay. Where's Jackie at? Yeah. Hey, how's it going? Look, this is nothing. I'll be back. Couple weeks, I'll be ready. Red Hood, I'm coming for you. Hey, I'll see you. Not here. On the slides.
You might not see it on his face now, but this was a major blow to Pizzetti. He's had other hard falls, but I can't think of any other moment in his career more psychologically devastating.
Yeah, you know, I come from humble beginnings. You know, I started off sliding a banister in my home in Brooklyn.
Joe Pizzetti rose to the top of the New York slide world, pioneering new runs in the subway system.
You know, Brooklyn was great. It's just I felt stifled there. It's kind of like a poet. He's got five letters to say everything he wants to say. Coming to San Francisco, it's like suddenly got an entire alphabet.
Joe burst onto the Bay Area scene, but the steeper inclines and unpredictable weather conditions took its toll.
No doubt, I was a top guy in my sport, but I was getting hurt a lot, and I was spending more time in the ER than I was at the meets.
After a couple of years of taking his hard knocks, it all changed when he met Grovesberg.
I took a slide. I'd taken it like 20 times before. This time, I go flying into the bushes. This guy comes over, offers me a hand up. He mentions something about making me a better slider. I hear that kind of thing all the time, but usually it's so much of this. With Grovesberg, it was different.
Thanks to Grovesberg and his revolutionary pants rail technology, Pizzetti stayed injury-free and began his unparalleled domination of the sport. Until the lion.
I think he could use the company. He'll be happy to see you guys, so you know, might as well try it. Although he does think that you and Red Hood were working together.
You know what? Here's the key. I ain't doing this every fucking day. Come in. You guys are out here.
Scoop, you think we're gonna get in?
I don't know. I'll try to get you in. Hey, Joe!
Yo, what's up, Grovesy?
Can I bring these guys up?
No, come on up.
I got a good shot. I've been talking to him. I think today is the day.
Yo, they ain't coming up.
Pizzetti's instituted a complete media blackout.
Well, he's definitely getting better, so I think I can get you up today. We'll give it a shot. Hey, Joe. Joe, can I bring the guys up? Joe?
This is the media's first opportunity in almost a month to see Pizzetti.
Joe.
And it's not looking good. Despite the happy face he's been putting on things, Joe. Grovesberg looks shaken.
Well, at least he's alive. Wearing sweatpants. I'm gonna have to take him to see McVail.
It's a sweater for them to grip on. I cut it off because it's so fucking hot in the summer, but they can't. I take them on a bike now, I go on rides, so. I mean, on my shoulders, so. They need something they can really grip. I had their nails clipped because it's too dangerous to have a nut. There we go. Now, chew through that, you little fucker.
Ah, the great McVail. As tough as they come, and the only slider to outdo Bone Cheek Moskowitz. A slide rail legend and a true hero to Pizzetti.
When there were wood railings out there, he'd take a wood railing bare ass. And not only could he take it full speed, the guy could take it no splinters.
You ready?
Yeah.
McPhail will set you right.
All right.
Put your head back together.
Yeah. McPhail.
Joe, come in. Come in, baby. Give me a good one.
Yeah. Good to see you, man.
You still sliding the camel?
Oh, the camel, no, man. I'm retired these days.
I don't know how you did those double arms.
You don't know. I thought I taught you, man.
Well, you told me a lot of stuff, but obviously not enough.
The bird jungle, huh?
Yeah, the birds are sleeping in the bathroom, okay? So, here. Here's your bathroom. In case you gotta take a leak.
All right.
Excuse me, guys. Gotta close it, okay? Take care. I want you to sit.
McPhail implements a monk-like regimen for Pizzetti, making him spend long hours sitting on a stone floor. As the days wear on, Pizzetti faces untold physical and mental pain, with the hope that this will focus his mind and sharpen his ass.
This is Grovesberg. I just wanted to let you know, you're welcome to come down and film the workout, and we would love for you to show up for the slide-off. Also, he apologizes for punching the grip.
Yes.
We got a lot of work to do. Come and see my lab. Working on some new pants right now.
As the clouds roll across the bay, rain falls intermittently. Grovesberg casually makes last-minute calculations and final adjustments. Clearly, he's one confident Sherpa. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the big day. Welcome to the slide-off. You can see our two competitors. Red Hood, a big red question mark. They say he's a stuntman. Is he Southern? We don't know. He won't talk to the media. And of course, Pizzetti with Grovesberg at his side. You can be sure Pizzetti's fans are glad to have him back in fighting form.
I'm Sasha, and I'm Joe's Reiki healer. And, you know, Joe comes to me all the time. He always has all these injuries. He's always getting hurt. So I'm here to support him and just send him some really good energy today.
Above the crowd, looking over the proceedings, we see the great McPhail. Also in attendance, the always lovely Jorge Mendez. A protege of Pizzetti's and pioneer of style sliding.
I'm really into Joe. He's taught me a lot. And I'm just honored to be in the same city as a man with so much talent in slide rail. I came just to kind of, you know, for the slide off and just to be part of the whole experience.
Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go.
All right, Joe. You're ready. You got this.
I got it.
This is your city. Slide right into it.
All right, everybody. We're gonna get started with the slide-off. We got Professor Kittenberger calling the winner at the bottom. On my left, Joe Pizzetti.
Woo!
Good job!
Joe Pizzetti!
Right, this guy in the red hood. First one to the bottom wins, and if you fall off, you're out. On my mark.
Come on, Joe!
Come on, Joe!
Let's go, Joe! What's up? Yo, West Portal, Joe Pizzetti's back. Go ahead, is. Yeah. Hey, I just want to give a shout out to my friends in Germany. Got a big following in Berlin. Dolph, Ludwig, Helmet, keep sliding.
Joe,
So
you nailed it. But I think you actually lost that.
Oh, sure.
Ah, fuck.
Number two!
Yeah!
Hey, sweetheart.
Hi, babe.
I'm really glad you came.
I'm glad I came too. You did a good job.
I'm really sorry. Training has begun again.
I couldn't be happier about how this went down. The pants did exactly what I was hoping for. I mean, they dealt with the aluminum problem. There's a bit of aluminum on here, but there was no wobble in his ride. And, you know, the most important thing for me is look at how happy he is, look at how exuberant he's back. And that's one of the main reasons I designed the pants, was the ultimate sensation for sliding. Not so much for speed, it's to make him feel good about what he was doing again, and it worked. The spontaneous combustion problems I was working on, a little worried about that, they came through with flying colors, so this is a complete success in my books.
You wanna know what makes me tick? That right there, that metal bar, the sound of that, whoosh, that's like my heartbeat.